Bob is a grumpy bugger who works at a car yard. He's so old and cranky, people can barely understand what he's mumbling on about. Why on earth would they make him the customer service manager? The funny thing is, when I called him with a few special mumbles of my own, I actually did feel as if I had just been serviced.
Bob speaking.
Mr.
Speaking.
Yes, I've been giving you as a contact because I recently bought a Nissan. I'm not very happy with it because it's gone good to a deal.
Really?
It was bought with a warranty.
Yeah.
Okay, and I find myself not far down the path.
Yeah, right. See you later.
What do you mean, see you later? I want to deal with my warranty.
Yeah, well, that's good. If you start to speak properly, then I'll deal with you. Otherwise, I'm hanging up.
I am speaking properly. I can't.
Right.
I can't.
Okay.
Well, why are you talking to me like this?
Because I cannot understand what you're saying.
Well, I'm just trying to tell you that I purchased a car from you.
You told me that 3 times.
Okay, and when I'm driving it now along the highway, within 10, 15 kilometers, it just starts to get a bit lifted.
I'm not
talking
about this.
We were just talking about my car.
I know we're just talking about your car.
And the warranty. And
yes, I know about the warranty. You keep saying about the warranty. But then when you come to tell me what's wrong with the car, you cannot understand what I'm trying to tell you, and you don't understand what I'm telling you.
What? What do you...
You heard what I said.
I'm hearing what you're saying, but I'm just telling you the problem with my car, and you're abusing me, and I'm...
Yes, and then it goes...
What is that noise?
That's what you're saying.
Is this what you call customer service?
That's what it is, yes.
So you're telling me, right, that after my... I've got a 5,000 kilometer warranty, right? This is how you're going to treat me.
Correct. Unless you speak to me properly, I will not help you.
I've told you, when I'm driving along, after a while, the cabin starts to fill. It's smoking, okay?
Now it's smoking, is it?
That's what I've been saying to you all along.
No, you didn't. You said it's been... What sort of brand of smokes do you smoke?
I don't smoke.
Well, how come the car smoking?
That's why I'm ringing to talk to you, Mr. Genius.
Well, I want to find out when you bought the car, how many kilometers it's done, and if it's still under warranty.
Well, why can't I tell you that sort of... No. Huh? Tell me that.
Because I don't know what you said. That's what you said.
You're playing cuckoo, sir.
Yeah, you are a cuckoo, not me.
I just said to you, okay.
Okay, I'm going now.
I give you the information now over the phone so that we can move forward on this warranty.
Yeah, all right. What's the registration number of it?
P-R.
Yeah.
Right, okay. P-R. Well, did you get it?
I meet a code.
Why are you speaking to me like this?
Because that's what you said to me. P-R-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B-O-T-O-G-O-T-O-B- phone number?
953
9536
right? 88 88.
Thank you very much for ringing.
What do you...
Nice talking to you.
Right.
Fair enough.
Oh, come on.
What's he supposed
to do? Did you hear at the start
do?
The bloke go, hey, don't speak to a customer like that?
Yeah. Had to call him back.
Yeah.
Hello?
Mr.
This is the elephant scrubber again.
Why do you say that?
Oh, you sound like you should be scrubbing elephants.
Who's that laughing in the background? Who's your hyena friend, huh?
It'd be another elephant scrubber, I'd say.
So are you going to fix my car?
Because of the way you're carrying on, I'm not going to help you.
Carrying on, all I've done is give you my name, my phone number, my registration.
That doesn't even all work up.
Is that some kind of attempt to speak my language?
Well, that's what you started off. That's how you said it.
I did not. There must be something wrong with your phone.
Did you understand?
Tell me, are you the customer service officer for warranties at your car yard?
That's me.
Do you find that most customers are particularly pleased with the service that they receive?
They're that pleasing when after I've finished with the customer service with them, they always bring me in a slab of VB stubbies.
Right. Do you refer to perhaps people from Asia as Ching Chongers?
No.
Do you refer to people from Germany as dumb krauts?
No.
So why do you call me an elephant scrubber?
Well, that's what you people do, scrub elephants.
Do you not find this offensive in any way at all?
Not really.
And then you mock my language and talk crazy stuff at me.
Yeah, bully, bully, bully.
So will you be fixing my car?
Yeah, I'll fix it. You come and see me and I'll fix it. Not a problem.
I won't be bringing a slab for you.
That'll be right.
Oh, right, because what? Yeah, you've overextended.
You just come and see me and bring the slab of beer and I'll fix it. Bully, 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 bully.
You've extended your service so magnificently.
Yes, and so did you, but thank you very much for it. Bully, 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 bully.
I can only look forward to the wonderful success that you will enjoy over the coming months. Goodbye.
He is a little mad.
He is a bit mad, obviously close to retirement.
Oh, my God.
So I rang one of the car boys. I said, look, you know, I think he may need to do some work. He might need a training course or something. But most of all, we better let him know that it's actually a joke.
Mm.
Hello, Bob speaking. Bob, this Indian bloke's ringing me up driving me berserk. Listen, you I just had him on the phone for bloody 5 minutes. Did you check him out to see who he was? All he kept saying was, do you know who he is? No.
Hello, is that you, Mr. Bobby?
Oh, hell.
Bobby, this is a gotcha call on Fox FM.
Oh, gotcha. Come and just sell a bloody elephant's brother.
Did you think you gave a wonderful lesson in customer service there?
I think I certainly did.
It's Matt Tilley here from Fox FM.
Joking. I didn't think it was on the cuff. And then when I thought there might have been something wrong when you hung up when I said the woolly 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 woolly.
Oh, isn't this a lovely band? And